Donald J. Trump, the 45th President of the United States, has been a prominent figure not only in politics, but also in the world of business. Certainly, there have been presidents before him who were businessmen. Both George H.W. Bush and his son, George W., were in the oil business. Herbert Hoover was in mining, and Warren G. Harding was in the newspaper business. With a career spanning several decades, Trump has amassed significant wealth and numerous business accomplishments that have made him a household name. The difference is that every president before Trump had held one or more government positions before taking the office or had served as a general in the military. This means that Trump's business record and the performance of his companies were the public's only basis for measuring his professional performance before he became president. We know considerably more now, although there is still much to know. Here's what we know and don't know about Trump's business dealings, his successes and failures, and his financial health as he left the presidency. So, let's delve into his wealth, assets, and notable achievements in the business world. So let's get started. Mixing business and politics. Trump's potential conflicts of interest were a prominent topic throughout his tenure from 2017 through 2020. As president, the enormous power he had at his command made it more important than ever to understand his long list of businesses and how they could intersect with his public role as president. These conflicts of interest did not pose a legal problem for Trump. The president and vice president are explicitly exempt from ethics regulations concerning conflicts of interest. Getting a clear picture of the former president's businesses is further complicated by the fact that income and asset values are listed in very wide ranges. The Trump National Golf Club in Charlotte is listed as worth between $5 million and $25 million. Trump's current wealth. Despite these obstacles, valuable information can be gleaned from Trump's financial disclosures, especially in concert with other information. We have used financial disclosures and a plethora of other sources to come up with an estimate of Trump's net worth after he left office. The publication currently pegs it at around $2.4 billion. This should be regarded as a rough estimate, even though the publication did as thorough a job as possible given the dearth of information. This $2.4 billion represents a significant drop, having fallen from $3.1 billion since the end of 2019. This is largely due to the damage COVID-19 has done to the hotel and casino industries. The real sources of wealth, the former president's businesses generally fall into five categories: hotels, golf courses, or some combination of the two, condos, residential and commercial real estate rentals, and payments for the licensing of Trump's name. The New York Times articles unleashed a major new source of information. Besides confirming that Donald Trump's disclosed income numbers were actually revenue figures, the numbers also show that companies owned by Trump were incredibly unprofitable for the period between 2000 and 2018. His real sources of income were a television show and some licensing deals. Although certain enterprises such as Trump Tower have been profitable, Trump businesses overall lost $174.5 million from 2000-2018. During the same period of time, his net income from licensing and endorsement deals was $230 million. His net income from The Apprentice television show was $197.3 million, and his income from other investments in companies run by other people was $178.7 million. Top 5 businesses owned by Donald Trump. Number 1, Trump National Doral. Business type: golf resort. What is now the Trump National Doral Golf Resort was founded in 1962 in Doral, near Miami. Trump bought the resort out of bankruptcy for $150 million in 2012. The Doral was the source of considerable controversy in 2019, when the former president announced plans to hold the 2020 meeting of the G7 at Trump National Doral. He withdrew the proposal after accusations that this was an attempt to profit from his presidency. Number 2, Trump Old Post Office LLC. Business type: hotel. This business is a holding company for the Trump International Hotel in Washington, D.C., which operates in the Old Post Office Building, a national landmark. Trump's company holds a long-term lease on the property, owned by the U.S. government, which could last nearly 100 years with extensions. The hotel was at the center of a major emoluments case against the former president. A group of hotel and restaurant owners sued Trump for violating the emoluments clause, alleging that he was unconstitutionally profiting from his office because his hotel gets the business of foreign officials staying there to curry his favor. The group argued that this gave the former president's hotel an unfair competitive advantage against their businesses. Possibly as a result of lawsuits and public criticism, the Trump Organization planned to sell its lease to the property. They were seeking a purchase price of more than $500 million, one of the highest-priced hotel deals per room ever. The sale process was placed on hold due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Number 3. Trump Ruffin Tower, LLC. Business type, hotel and condominium complex. Trump Ruffin. Tower LLC manages the Trump International Hotel and Tower in Las Vegas. Constructed in 2008, the tower is a combination hotel and condominium development. It struggled as the Great Recession hit when it opened more than a decade ago, devastating the real estate market. Plans for a second tower were scrapped. Number 4. Trump Turnberry. Business type, golf resort. Originally built in 1906 by Archibald Kennedy, the third Marquess of Ailsa, Trump Turnberry is one of two golf resorts the former president owns in Scotland. Trump purchased the Turnberry Resort from a Dubai-based company for an undisclosed sum. Number 5. Mar-a-Lago Club, LLC. Business type, hotel and resort. The Mar-a-Lago Club was built as a private mansion in 1927 by Marjorie Meriwether Post, who inherited the Postum Cereal Company, which later became the General Foods Corporation. Mrs. Marjorie Meriwether Post is dead at 86. In 1968, she decided to donate Mar-a-Lago to the U.S. government to serve as a winter White House. When she died in 1973, the government refused the gift due to its high maintenance costs. The estate was purchased by Trump in 1985 for a reported $8 million. He used it as a winter White House and continues to operate it as a private resort club. Donald Trump's wealth, assets, and business accomplishments have made him a prominent figure in both business and politics. While his career has been marked by successes and controversies, there is no denying his impact on the business world. Whether through his real estate empire, the Trump brand, or his media presence, Donald Trump's business legacy will continue to be a subject of fascination and study for years to come. If you enjoyed this deep dive, don't forget to give us a thumbs up, share your thoughts in the comments below, and subscribe for more profiles of influential figures. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you in the next video.